Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video I will cover ISRO Technical Assistant Mahendragiri paper. I will cover 2016 paper. Question is, potential energy of 2 kg of water at 2 meters from the datum is about how much? So potential energy, it's mgh, mass is given 2 kg into g is, take a 10, then h is 2 meter, 40 joule. A is your correct answer. Sorry, A is 2000 joule. B is your correct answer, 40 joule. The question is, the number of instantaneous centers for 8 links kinematic chain is, so number of links n equal to 8. Our formula for instantaneous center IC, n into n minus 1 by 2, put the value of n, 8 links, 8 into 8 minus 1, directly you can write 7, 28, not available in the option, so none of the above, this is your answer. Question is, TQM focuses on supplier, employer and customer. The correct answer, TQM is total quality management. It's not focused for supplier, so one is not possible. Employee and customer, two correct, customer also correct. So from option 1 and 3, 3 only, 2 and 3, C is your correct answer. SI unit of specific heat capacity. So specific heat capacity, watt per meter Kelvin, this is for your thermal conductivity, then kg meter cube, density, this is your pressure unit, then last one, joule per kg Kelvin. If you don't know also, you can use method of elimination and you can get your answer. Question is, in case of pier bending, the beam will bend into arc of radius, arc of circle, parabola. D is your correct answer. The energy of an isolated system means no change in a process is increases, no, decreases, no, remains constant. C is your correct answer. Young's modulus of elasticity of a mild steel is, it's 210 gigapascal. This is your correct answer. B is your correct answer. Question is, an optimum project schedule implies optimum utilization of man machine material, timely execution of project, then this is also possible, then lowest possible cost and shortest possible time, this is the best option. C is your correct answer. To produce best results under given constraints, no, not possible. C is your best option. Question is, the moment of inertia of a rectangle with base 3 cm and height 4 cm about an axis through center of gravity and parallel to base is how much? So, it's a rectangle. Height is more. Base is 3 cm. Height is 4 cm. We have to calculate moment of inertia of a rectangle with base 3 cm about axis through CG and parallel to base. This is your base. This is BB. This is center of gravity point G. Parallel to base means this one. That this is XX axis. IXX we have to find out. And we know our at center of gravity, our moment of inertia is minimum. It's BH cube by 12. So base is 3, H cube 4 into 16, or 4q also you can write. 4 into 16 I am writing, by 12, 3 into 4, 12, 16 is your answer. 16 centimeter to the power 4. A is your correct answer. If they will ask at base also you can calculate. IBB. Use parallel axis theorem. It's IXX at center of gravity plus area into distance square. Distance is your, let this distance is X, A X square. IXX BHQ by 12 plus area is B into H into X you will get, it's H by 2, it's square. So you will get BHQ by 12, or directly you can use formula also, BHQ by 4, then 12, 3 BHQ, sorry it's 4 BHQ, 4 BHQ, finally you will get BHQ by 3. So again I am writing here, moment of inertia along base you will get BHQ by 3, put the value of B, 3 into 4q divided by 3 cancel, 64 centimeter to the power 4. If they will ask along base also you can answer directly, you can put this formula also if you remember this one, otherwise you can find out by using parallel axis theorem. The heat required to raise the temperature of 1 kg of water from room temperature by 1 Kelvin, Cp of water or C of water, it's 4.18, unit is kilojoule. This unit you have to careful, here kilocalorie available, here kilojoule available, here also joule available. All are having 4.18, this is your correct answer, kilojoule. Question is, pressure at a certain depth below ocean surface is 1.4 megapascal. What is the depth approximately? So, pressure given P equal to 1.4 megapascal or 1.4 newton per mm square. You can write it as 1.4 into 10 power 6 newton per meter square, because all options are in a meter. So, you convert it to newton per meter square. So, we know this is ocean, means you take water density value 10 to power 3 kg per meter cube. Then we know pressure formula P equal to rho g h. We have to calculate the depth, means h value we have to calculate. G also you take 10. Then P equal to 1.4 into 10 power 6. It's equal to water density 10 to power 3 g 10. H value have to calculate. H equal to, here you will get 1.4 into 100. So you can write it as 14 meter. A is your correct answer. Wait a minute. I will cross check this one. 10 to power 3 here 100. If you multiply 100, you will get here 1.4 megapascal, 1.4 into 10 to power 6, this is correct. Then density 10 to power 3 kg per meter cube, this is also correct. G value 10, so 10 to power 6 divided by 10 to power 4, you will get 100. Then 100 into 1.4, you can write it as 14 by 10, 10 cancel, 140. It's 140 meter. B is your correct answer. Question is, addition of detergent to liquid, detergent addition decreases surface tension. So from option, lower surface tension, C is your correct answer. Hydraulic press works on basis of its Pascal law, same pressure in all direction. B is your correct answer. When a cyclist moves to on a curved path, he or she tends to remain vertical, not possible, bend outwards, no, bend inwards, then bend horizontal, not possible, none of the above. Your bend inwards not available, so none of the above. D is your correct answer. Father of time study, it's F.W. Taylor. As percentage of carbon increases in steel, its toughness decreases, then ductility also decreases. So from option, corrosion resistance, no, ductility. B is your correct answer. Question is, in ABC analysis, A class consists of items, always better control, inventory control. A class consists of good records, minimal records, accurate records also available. So I think C1, accurate records should require. A class consists of yes, accurate record is the best option. Then A class, it consists of highest cost and lowest quantity. The wet valve temperature is a measure of its absolute humidity. B is your correct answer. Question is, mass of vapor is 1 kg of wet steam of dryness fraction 0.95 is how much? So we have to calculate mass of vapor. 1 kg of wet steam means mass of vapor plus mass of liquid is 1 kg, or total mass is 1 kg. Dryness fraction x is 0.95, we know our formula, x equal to mass of vapor divided by mass of vapor plus mass of liquid. So mass of vapor is, we have to calculate that one, 0.95 equal to mv divided by total mass is 1 kg. So mv equal to 0.95. This is in kg, so 0.95 kg not available, so go for gram, 950 gram, A is your option, correct option. Question is, a cantilever and a simply supported beam or SS beam have same length and are subjected to same UDL load, the ratio of their maximum bending moment is how much? So first you take the cantilever, both are subjected to UDL, same UDL, let the UDL is omega Newton per meter. Second case, it's cantilever, let the points are A and B point, subjected to same UDL, omega Newton per meter. We have to calculate the ratio of their maximum bending moment. In case of cantilever, or let this is 1, simply supported beam consider as 2. So M1 maximum at fixed end, so omega into L, if the length is L, omega into L is your total load, into center of gravity will come at midpoint. So from center of gravity to fixed end distance L by 2 omega L square by 2. Then in case of simply supported beam, maximum bending moment you will get at midpoint. This is L by 2 distance. Total load is same omega into L. So RA and RB, you will get omega into L by 2, here also omega into L by 2. Bending moment you will get M2 maximum. Up to midpoint, let this point is C. At C point, your load is RB into distance is L by 2 minus omega into L by 2 into L by 4. You will get RB is omega L by 2 into L by 2 minus omega L square by 8. 2 omega L square minus omega L square by 8. So M1 by M2 we have to calculate. M1 by M2 omega L square by 2 into 8 by omega L square. 4 is your correct answer. Directly also you can answer this question if you remember the moment formulas, then directly within one step also you can answer this question. So if you remember the formula, then you can save the time. Otherwise, you can derive the formula also, then you can answer this question. Next question, the general law of expansion or compression PV to the power n is C. The process is said to be hyperbolic. If n is equal to, for hyperbolic process we know PV is constant, product of pressure into volume is constant, or your internal energy change is equal to enthalpy change. Change in internal energy it's equal to change in enthalpy, n equal to 1. And for superheated steam, isothermal and hyperbolic process both are identical. So PV equal to constant, or PV to the power 1 is constant. So n equal to 1. N equal to infinity, this is for constant volume process, volume is constant. N equal to 0, constant pressure process. N equal to gamma, adiabatic process. PV to the power gamma is constant. Reversible adiabatic or isentropic process. Question number 53. For complete combustion of 1 kg of carbon, the required oxygen is, this is also repeating, many times this question is repeating, it's 8 by 3 kg of oxygen. B is your correct answer. You just remember this one, they are repeating this question. This one also repeating, which of the following conversion formula is correct for temperature units? So Celsius by 100, it's equal to Fahrenheit minus 32 by 180, Rankine minus 492 divided by 180. A is your correct answer. For any reversible adiabatic process, the change in entropy is how much? Reversible adiabatic process is PV to the power gamma is constant. If you follow Otto cycle PV diagram, you will get like this. 1 to 2 and here 3 to 4 both are reversible adiabatic process. 1 to 2 is your reversible adiabatic compression process, and 3 to 4 is your reversible adiabatic expansion process. PV to the power gamma is constant. So if you follow its TS diagram, it will come like this. 1 to 2 and here 3 to 4 both are isentropic process. So here entropy is same, S1 equal to S2, and 3 to 4 also isentropic expansion process, S3 equal to S4. So change in entropy del S in process 1 to 2, S1 minus S2 is 0, and for process 3 to 4 del S 3 to 4 S3 minus S4, because both are same, you will get 0 value. 0 is your correct answer. Question is, drag and lift forces acting on an object placed in a fluid stream are caused by pressure and viscosity. Your gravity available, turbulence, pressure and viscosity. A is your correct answer. When Froude number is more than 1, then the flow is turbulent. First, I will explain one important graph for Froude number. Froude number versus Q maximum. Maximum, sorry, it's Q or flow rate. Froude number versus your flow rate. Sorry, it's depth versus your flow rate. D versus Q. Your graph will come like this. It will come, your graph. Here at critical depth or DH, you will get maximum flow. This is also very, very important. Many times they are asking SSCJ. For SSCJ, this is very, very important. Here, at critical depth, Froude number equal to 1. Then above critical depth, Froude number is less than 1. Or subcritical. And here, Froude number is greater than 1. Supercritical. And one more thing you have to remember, this one. This one also very, very important. At Froude number equal to 1 or at critical, your depth is your critical depth, Q is maximum, flow is your maximum. Then subcritical, its Froude number is less than 1, supercritical, Froude number is greater than 1. Here, Froude number is more than 1, FR is more than 1 for supercritical. Critical flow, FR equal to 1, then subcritical, FR is less than 1. Streaming flow, not. D is your best option. Question number 58. The unit power of turbine is PU equal to P by H to the power 3 by 2. Unit discharge Q equal to Q by H to the power 1 by 2. Unit speed H to the power 1 by 2. So from option unit power, H to the power P by H to the power 2. C is your correct answer. Dash at the highest value of Poisson's ratio. Poisson's ratio is mu. Concrete mu is around 0.2. For wood, wood also less than 0.1. Then your steel, steel around 2.5 to 2.3. So you take, sorry, it's not 2.3, it's 0.3. Then rubber, it's 0.5. Rubber is maximum. Dash at the highest value of Poisson's ratio. Cork is having 0. Your concrete 0.2, then wood is less than 0.1, steel around 0.3, then rubber 0.5, rubber is having maximum value. Then question is, Grashof number has significant role in heat transfer way. This is for natural convection. Conduction, your Fourier law. Natural convection, forced convection, then radiation. Grashof number is for natural convection. जी आर इक्वल टू जी बीटा टी एस माइनस टी इन्फिनिटी देन योर एल सी एल सी क्यू देन योर काइनेमेटिक विस्कोसिटी विल गेट काइनेमेटिक विस्कोसिटी स्क्वायर बुयांसी फोर्स डिवाइडेड बाय योर विस्कस फोर्स. दिस वन यू रिमेम्बर. दिस वन नॉट दैट मच इम्पोर्टेंट. दिस वन इज इम्पोर्टेंट. ग्रासअप नंबर इज बुयांसी फोर्स बाय विस्कस फोर्स. दिस इज एंड ऑफ महेंद्रगिरी पेपर. ऑलरेडी टू पेपर्स आई ऑलरेडी सॉल्व. थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग माई वीडियो. थैंक यू.